Walking, ideally, is a state in which the mind, the body, and the world are aligned, as though they were three characters finally in conversation together, three notes suddenly making a chord. Walking allows us to be in our bodies and in the world without being made busy by them. It leaves us free to think without being wholly lost in our thoughts. Foot seems to make it easier to move in time. The mind wanders from plans to recollections to observations. The walker toiling along a road towards some distant place is one of the most compelling and universal images of what it means to be human, depicting the individual as small and solitary in a large world reliant on the strength of body and will. Have always offered anonymity, variety, and conjunction, qualities best basked in by walking. A city always contains more than any inhabitant can know, and a great city always makes the unknown and the possible spurs to the imagination. The average rural walker looks at the general, the view, the beauty, and the landscape moves by as a gently modulated continuity. A crest long in view is reached, a forest thins out to become a meadow. The urbanite is on the lookout for particulars, for opportunities, individuals and supplies, and the changes are abrupt. Walkers are practitioners of the city, for the city is made to be walked, Debord wrote. A city is a language, a repository of possibilities, and walking is the act of speaking that language, of selecting from those possibilities. Just as language limits what can be said, architecture limits where one can walk, but the walker invents other ways to go. Walking generates a kind of rhythm of thinking, and the passage through a landscape echoes or stimulates the passage through a series of thoughts. This creates an odd consonance between internal and external passage, one that suggests that the mind is also a landscape of sorts, and that walking is one way to traverse it. A new thought often seems like a feature of the landscape that was there all along, as though thinking were traveling rather than making. And so one aspect of the history of walking is the history of thinking made concrete, for the motions of the mind cannot be traced, but those of the feet can. Subtle state most dedicated urban walkers know, sort of basking in solitude, a dark solitude punctuated with encounters as the night sky is punctuated with stars. In the country, one's solitude is geographical, one is altogether outside society, so solitude has a sensible geographical explanation, and then there is a kind of communion with the non-human. In the city, one is alone because the world is made up of strangers. And to be a stranger surrounded by strangers, to walk along silently bearing one's secrets and imagining those of the people one passes, is among the starkest of luxuries.
Who wander, all those who wander, all those who